Hello and welcome aboard WhalePod to another episode of Xenoblade Chronicles 3. I am your Captain Whale, and in today's episode, we are going to be getting back on track with the main story after finally figuring out what that quest marker up on the upper level of the Millic Meadows was. It was Gray, who is now in our party as we have shifted around some classes. In the last video, Noah and Mio each reached rank 10 respectively in Heavy Guard on Noah and Ogre on Mio. So in order to facilitate some different party layouts that can allow us to bring Gray with us, we have switched Mio back to Zephyr for the time being and Noah back to Swordfighter. We will still be controlling Yuni, who is still working through the ranks of Flash Fencer. However, now that she has reached rank 5, her capabilities have improved slightly, meaning she will perform better, hopefully. Tion is also still in his Thaumaturge class, as he is still climbing the ranks there. Lanz is our new second defender, as we have swapped our defender hero Xeon for our attacker hero Gray. Lanz has already mastered Zephyr and Heavy Guard, so we put him into Guardian Commander, which he has a B-level aptitude in, making him middle of the pack for how fast he ranks up within Guardian Commander. Senna is still working through Medic Gunner, like the good girl she is, trudging through even though it's only a C rank aptitude for her. And Gray is with us, and he is pretty darn cool. Not only is his class and a lot of his arts just living, walking Xenoblade Chronicles X references, which I love. Xenoblade Chronicles X is amazing. Its combat system is very breakable. If you do have a Wii U still, I highly recommend picking up and giving Xenoblade Chronicles X a try. It is the closest thing to a Wii U MMO you will probably ever experience. Even if you don't have a Wii U but are a fan of the Xenoblade series, I highly recommend you pick up a Wii U and a copy of Xenoblade Chronicles X just to play Xenoblade Chronicles X. It is that good. Or you could be lazy and slightly dubious on the legality side of things and just emulate X, because I believe it can be emulated on PC. But don't do that. Support Nintendo. Buy yourself a Wii U and buy yourself a Xenoblade Chronicles X. Show them that even now it's still, well, now more than ever, it is definitely worth the expense of porting over to the Switch. Even though that would mean dealing with the rights holders to the game soundtrack. Now, a couple housekeeping items before we get into the bulk of the video. I will no longer be showing all container locations that I find on camera. They are getting very samey as we progress through the game, with most colony containers containing gemstone and sellables, maybe an accessory or two, and most Nopon Caravan containers containing, once again, some sellables, and then maybe an accessory or two, but swapping the gemstones for Nopon coins. They're scattered literally everywhere. There are beams of light that make that coming from the tops of them that make them harder to miss. You still can miss them, but they are harder to miss. So we will not be taking the time to run over to all those places on camera and gather them all. Hence, streamlining these videos hopefully in the future. Another change to hopefully streamline things is I will, in most cases, not be showing my first defeat of a unique monster on camera, but will be showing off unique monsters that I defeated off camera on camera, as we can teleport to the named tombstone and streamline that process. Now, let's get into the video. We are warning level 3 with Kevis still and warning level 0 with Agnes still. Gray is not associated with any colony, so there was no colony liberation involved in Gray's story quest, nor was there a Mobius or Consul battle like in other story quests such as Xeon, Teach, and Valdi. On the topic of Valdi, Valdi is not in my party yet because, one, I want to get Senna and Tion to rank 10 in Medic Gunner and Thaumaturge respectively first, and two, because I just don't like Valdi. I think so far he's my least favorite character we've encountered in this game. Even Jeremy, whose whole personality is I hate Agnes and I hate you because you associate with Agnes, is a better character than Valdi, in my opinion. Fight me over it. I dare you. And now, we are going to get into the start of this video with a little bit of cleanup before going into the story. We are outside in Ribby Flats in the desolate little wasteland area where Valdi keeps his secret stash of parts, outside a location known as the Turken Headquarters. The Turken Headquarters also appeared in Xenoblade Chronicles, somewhere on the Bionis leg, and it contained a unique monster at the back. Let's see if these Turken have a boss at the back as well.
Gonna blast them into next week.
A good test for my blade. First strike.
What blade? You wield frickin' guns. I get it now. Blade has a different meaning in Xenoblade Chronicles X. Maybe he's making another sneaky little X reference there. If so, I like it. This would be definitely a very difficult fight at a somewhat close to same level as these enemies, as all these enemies have, as they are humanoids and their pets working in close tandem with each other, pack mentality, and an attack against one is considered an attack against all. See, this bard Turken jumped in to help his friend. No, you weren't, Lanz. Spear Turkey? We will be completely clearing Turken Headquarters, as is this more fun that way. It's more flavorful to walking in, storming the Turken's house, and telling them what's what, if you're actually going to finish the job. We no longer have an ogre in the party, though. So right now, we do not have any way to get a launch for Yuni's smash on her talent art, unfortunately. But we still have a full burst combo.
Gonna blast them into next week. We can do it. No doubt about it.
And I was the MVP. You were all thinking it.
Let's get it done snappy. We can do it. No doubt about it.
Break!
You want to touch?
Come here! I got something for you.
Eyes over here! Thanks for the support.
What? Extra!
Come on, you!
Drop us another!
Divine
power!
Come here! I got something for you!
Good timing.
We're unstoppable with you around, Senna.
I'm the girl with the gall.
Also, by bringing Gray with us, even though we have not yet reclassed Uni into a full metal jaguar, we can be working on others level up in the full metal jaguar class.
Giant!
You're
in free now! Right,
One elite down.
With you around, Senna.
I'm the girl with the gall. Gonna blast them into next week.
Safe colonies with me on the job.
Why, slap!
Come here! I got something
Eyes over
for
here!
You.
Thanks for the support.
Head thrust!
That was mine for the
full
blast! Well done, Senna!
Ha.
Revolution! Get flooded!
Why,
slap! Myopic scream! Keep up the pressure!
Why,
Hear that, Noah? Lance wants something a bit.
Aha, there is a unique monster back here.
Let's get his unsnappy. We can
take out the last of the chief's guards. Before we go to fight the chief himself. The chief is surrounded by quite a few of his retainers. Let's take them out first.
That was spectacular.
And I was the MVP.
This would definitely be a much tougher fight if they would all aggro us. Now that we've cleared away the retainers, time to beat up Boss Man here. The Hedonist Turkin is this guy's name. Level 3. Nice, guys.
Deflection.
Divine protection.
What impact?
Hold on tight.
chain attack on the launch.
Hit them where they least expect. I might have the answer.
I use my thinking muscles for this one.
I'll lead.
You're in for it now. Gonna dish out as much as I can.
All right, Gray is back in action. Gray's attacks all look just so cool. So yeah, Gray there was increasing the damage ratio by an extra 1.5 times each time we completed an order that he participated in. Yeah, we are nearing the cap on Aether, so I would really like to find a Feranis Hulk to waste it on sooner rather than later. It also would appear that in Chain Attacks, heroes, in addition to having unique orders that don't use Chain Gauge, also have unique roles different from your standard attacker, defender, and healer that the main six get.
It'd be rude not to.
When using Teach and Chain attacks, I on multiple occasions did see some instances where Teach would still push over 100% to completion despite Teach being a healer. So keep that in mind when using a hero when fulfilling an order. A healer will not cap at 99% if that healer is a hero. And if you're using a defender, they will not get the guaranteed reactivation for the highest point value member who is currently sitting on the bench like a standard defender will. You'll still get a reactivation. It'll just, I believe, be random. Now, rather than walking around in Turken headquarters as much as I would like to, we have one more unique monster to take care of. Hedonist Turken was taken down in here already. And that is... all the way over here, we found... Unruffled Nara. Oh, we also won't be holding off on using the, or doing the first time through a enemy conflict out in the open world. Just know that if anything gives Nopon coins, I will be supporting them. If there are no Nopon coins on the table, I will go for anything that isn't just golden experience.
You ready for this?
Let's fight Unruffled Nara again. She is a big ol' Armu.
You hit first.
Big ol' Armu Mama. And our Hedonist Turk in there was actually pretty tanky if he managed to be that low level compared to us, but still survive until we had a chain gauge built up, even with two rank 3 Ouroboros speeding on him. Nara is not nearly as powerful, so she won't last nearly as long against the combined force of the 7 of us. You see, that's kind of what I want. I kind of want something like she has here, where it's an AoE break all around me. And she goes down quite quickly.
We can do this
way too soon.
Hear that, Noah? Lance wants something a bit meatier.
Iron headband. I wonder if that's higher quality than the ice headbands we have. Now we're going to quickly grab this supply drop, as this one tends to be unguarded. This is adding even more urgency to we need to find a Feranus Hulk, because this will give us even more ether. Alright, Uni, Senna, crack it open, girls. Yep, there's yet another ether cylinder. And more gemstones were capped on. I've been going around off camera farming what I can possibly farm for gem crafting wise. And I'll just say right now that even though most of our gems are still level 2 and only a few have gone up to level 3, we don't have any we can craft. We need things from areas past where we are now. So let's get past where we are now and climb up Elsie's spout.
Let's cut through while they're keeping each other busy.
This is one I have not done before because I did not know it was here. We have Plains Turkens versus the Tableland Turkens. We're gonna side with the Tableland Turkens because they give us nop on coins. And it would also appear that interspecies conflict, or intraspecies conflict as this may be, is not a solely human condition, as these two Turkens are from different tribes, but still just as happy as always to beat each other up. Or should I say, happy to beat each other up despite being just a different nationality or regionality of the same larger species, the Turken. And by jumping across these rocks here, obviously, there's going to be another Turken fight up these cliffs. We can kind of hear it from here already. or partway up the cliffs. We will assist the Tablelands Turkens again, because once again, I will do anything for a Nopon coin. Or a Klondike bar. One of those two things. And we get our Nopon coins.
Come after me, and that's what you get.
If only you didn't charge off on your own.
What's this? Maybe some kind of construction core left it behind?
We will be able to ride that eventually. We just need another field skill in order to ride down those rails.
Time for a climb.
Looks like a new location.
Oh, nicely done.
Fornus Region, Raybell Tableland.
That's funny. I'd never noticed that before.
Oh, do they not have Armus where you're from?
Yeah, I meant getting old. Is that what that is?
It's called getting old, this.
That smaller Armu over there. It starts little, but grows over time. Becomes like the bigger one. All the creatures do it. But we never change that much.
Ah.
It's such a basic fact. So why haven't we realized it before?
Realization leads to hope, which in due time turns to despair. The significance of the stasis is driven ever deeper within.
A moment in time, a sublime experience. That brilliance, it shines ascendant over all else.
That's why it takes so much frickin' work. Working stinks.
They all learn sooner or later. They learn how priceless it was, how grossly irreplaceable. The eclipse grows near.
They get along nice. Must be good friends.
It's funny. Just looking at these guys. It puts your mind at ease.
Hmm.
Is it an effect of becoming Ouroboros?
Good question. Still, I think I could get used to this.
Yeah. Me too.
And as soon as Noah and Mio are done having their existential crisis while looking at dinosaur cows, we have an Agnes airdrop some way over there. We can actually see where they land on the map, so let's see if that's the case here. Looks like it must be on the map, to see it on the, well, map. And we'll find it eventually. It's not like the enemy soldiers that find those things ever actually open them.
I'd better send them off.
Ankelardunes are here. And Dahlia Armu, which are higher level than the ones found down in the Ribby Flats, below the Tablelands.
It's another thing to see it for yourself, eh?
Tableland Turkins, you guys win again.
Let's get it done, Snappy. We can do it, no doubt about it.
I'm not getting to see if they drop anything different than these Turkin. Because I keep assisting the Turkin we've been fighting already. Or, keep fighting the Turkin we've been fighting already, assisting the new Turkin. And we get our thank you from the Turkins. I'm guessing they're just giving us these Nopon coins because they don't know what the heck to do with them. Other than, ooh, shiny, must be valuable. Crow brain, tell me to pick up. There's the big boy we saw flying around in the cutscene. I don't know if we'll be able to target it from here, but that is an example of a Serprond. A type of enemy introduced in Xenoblade Chronicles 2. It's fun to see these fish enemies flying around all these places they weren't before. Even though the, Marins were indeed in the desert in Torna. Ankle Arden, a little bit meatier than the Ardens down at lower altitudes.
The strength, it's amazing.
That's quite rare.
Well, now, and look here, challenge. Tenderling Rumi. Am I really gonna fight a baby for content? Why, of course I am.
This will be rough, but we got no choice.
Don't worry, I'll handle it.
Have I said before that Gray's arts look really cool? Let's turn it off, we've already drawn someone in. Nice burst there, Tyon. Pick up Mommy's meat.
Burning ring. Showdown.
Revolution.
We're gonna chain attack. During a chain attack, boost damage dealt to low HP enemies by 70%. Good one to start off with, Gray. I'll let you do the honors as well. With Executioner. Very nicely done, Gray, my boy. My man. Mio to guarantee we complete the order.
You can't get away. Watch this.
Reactivation on Gray, because he is a baller. And the overkill begins.
I'm with you. I was waiting for this. Let's bring it home. You're finished.
Gray is back in action once more.
I use my thinking muscles for this one. Alright, coming right up.
We'll lead off with Noah.
Only.
Gray again. Unfortunately, I don't think we get this one completed. Nope, no way. That is now the most damage we've ever done in a chain attack. Gray is really good at racking that up, apparently. Let's see where that overkill is, where these couple overkills have got us to on our ranks. Uni's partway up rank 6 now. Not bad for her being D rank in Flash Fencer, also known as the absolute slowest growth rate. Nop on container here.
Dude, all right here.
If I do get to close to 99 silver Nopon coins, though, I am going to spend some coins just ranking up some classes, because I don't want Nopon coins to start auto-selling. Gemstone going to rank 3, or I believe going to rank 4... is the last one that uses standard gemstone rather than needing pure gemstone. So it's okay to let those auto-sell because you don't need very many of them anyway. As after a certain point, all your gem crafting will take pure gemstone. Might be a bit of a waste if there's a later way to craft up more gemstone. Or more pure gemstone using your lower rarity stuff.
Something.
doodah right here.
Let's get it done, Snappy.
Now let's take it down.
With you around, Senna.
I'm the girl with the gall. Gonna blast them into next.
We need some drops from these guys for gem crafting. So we'll hunt a few of them down.
Pretty much what I expected. I'd say we were moving in sync, right, Tyon?
We're also gonna fight these land Ferris.
I'm so ready for this.
As Ferris materials are also needed for higher level gem crafts. You're glitching's bugging me, boy. With those three, we should have some Ferris items that are hopefully useful in gem crafting. This is a colony container. So at this specific point in time, it really just contains money and an all-nighter pot, whatever that is, some sort of collectible. Ah, the drop is over that way. I think we'll walk towards the drop. And then, once we've claimed it, maybe call that the end of the video? Maybe not. Who knows? Oopa are also needed for the next stage up gem crafting.
I don't think we'll run into any issues. I'll make this quick.
Come here. I got something for you. Thanks for the support.
Divine protection.
Yay!
Now I'm ready to make some waves.
Let's go take out a couple more Oopa.
Next week.
Let battle begin. Showdown.
Come here. I got something for you.
Thanks for the support.
Divine, I think we're unstoppable with you around, Senna.
I'm the girl with the gall.
This is our first time here, isn't it?
Come here. I got something for you.
Thanks for the support.
Violent flow!
It's over way too soon!
Hear that, Noah? Lance wants something a bit meatier. Let's get his hand snappy. All set and ready to tumble. You hit first swing!
Good going, Uni!
Come here! I got something for you!
Cheers, you're a gem!
Eyes over here!
Cheers, you're a gem!
Hey, good job, Uni!
Pushing up the odds a little.
Thanks for the support.
Stop!
We've got them pinned down! We're unstoppable with you around, Senna.
These Kramit appear to be a variety of Krabble that simply cram lots of junk into their shells. I like it. I like the play on words.
That was spectacular.
And I was the MVP. You were all thinking it.
Now, we've done enough just random maiming of the wildlife for now. Let's do what we intended to and claim this drop. Still finding Jagron fossils, so it could also be safe to assume this body of water will also have some dark fish fossils. And I think I know how we're starting next episode.
That's a strong opponent.
With Wraithfin Sengna. Very close to being Wraithfin Senna and having to beat up one of our own.
Looks like it's got something we can make use of.
Don't you mean it's gonna rhine, Lance? You're Kavesi. You should know the legend of the great hero Rhine.
Uni, take that end.
And we're the first to get to it, so free stuff. And that, everyone, is going to be the end of this episode of Xenoblade Chronicles 3. I have been your Captain Whale. If you liked this video, please leave a like and consider subbing to the channel. If you do sub to the channel, make sure to ring that notification bell to stay up to date with all my latest uploads. As always, comments are welcome down below. Feel free to leave one. Or feel free to answer the question of the day that I may or may not post in the comments. We'll see when this goes live. And until next time, Whale Pod, I hope you all are having fantastic days, and goodbye.